That's the list, six athletes. Just a reminder of how it works. 16 targets coming out of those high house and low house. You can see either side of the arena. 16 targets shot in four sections of four, so two sets of doubles from each station. Bronze and gold medal matches very much, as we just mentioned, for the semi-final. And if there needs to be a shoot-off, two targets at each time, so one double until we break the deadlock. Not shooting from all eight, we're shooting from positions three, four, and five, and then back to four in the final. Three is a reverse tricky. You don't shoot it in qualifying. Some shots in qualifying are just single shots. Four, a little bit more familiar. And then station five, the inverted one, opposite to station three. Rossetti to get us underway then. Years of age, bags the first couple. Nicely done, looking confident, hitting the targets early. Perfect conditions for these athletes. Here at this venue in the Diadora cluster of venues. Svensson up, no target caught. Because either a clay doesn't appear or it comes out broken. Again, seeing the targets very quickly. Going from low to high and then reversing it around again. Misses so far from these athletes. This is Jesper Hansen, two top five finishes this year in shooting competitions. Oh, and there is a first miss. Snatched it slightly. And so the 35-year-old from the KFK club doesn't have to go away and recompose himself. Nilsson, the second Swede in this competition. 26 years of age yesterday. I'm sure the celebrations have been put on hold. And first one missed there. Slight snatch, but he composed himself and kept going. Yeah. Now the veteran. Not the oldest here, though. Nikola Milchev. The gold medalist in Sydney, of course. Won the season opener in Nicosia in the World Cup. Yeah. Finally wearing the blue and gold of his home country. Of Ukraine. Now a man who's not under his nation's flag, a man from Kuwait, competing under the Olympic flag, Abdullah Alrashidi. Huge support for this man. Ninth, the best he's managed. Twice, once in Beijing, once in Athens, but he's gone better. He's in a final, and can he get a medal? Oh, I think that was a miss. Yes, it was. So three athletes with all four targets. Three athletes with three out of four. Just a quarter of a way through this semi-final, though. Remember, after the semi-final, we'll have a gold medal match and a bronze medal match. And this is how it stands after just four targets. All but one, of course, from Europe. These athletes know each other very well, spent a lot of time on the circuit. They'll be looking after number one here. Here's Rossetti, who started very well at his first Olympic Games. He's a very good junior record, a junior world champion, two junior European championships as well. No target called. Time clock goes back to 30. No penalisation of the athlete for that. Any time between 1 and 3 seconds after you call Paul. Into those microphones in front. That's when the birds are released. And there's only lots of drink of water. Svensson also looking very cool and collected. Seventh in London, just outside the final. Looks very comfortable, picking those clays up very easily. Hansen missed one last time round, he's missed another one there. So needs to pick it up a little bit. The man from Denmark. This is the man from not so far away. Trelleborg in Sweden. No target called, they'll shoot both of them again. And he misses the second one, so two misses for Hansen, two misses for Stefan Nilsson. Yeah. 2 days qualifying, and just a couple of wayward shots here, and all that good work can be undone. And Jeff, also been a coach for the Ukraine Skeet team, putting all his expertise, all those almost 49 years, to good use. He's sitting pretty alongside Rossetti and Svensson on 8 targets as we approach the halfway point of this semi-final. Alrashidi, 52 years of age, very nearly 53. Loves falconry. Very popular, of course, around the Middle East. Professional falconer, he describes himself as. Loves the skill of using birds in hunting, as many Arab nations have throughout the years. So halfway through, Rossetti, Svensson and Milchev all keeping pace with each other. Alrashidi, just the one miss, then Hansen and Nilsson on 6 out of 8. Rossetti to get us underway again. He has looked incredibly good thus far. Beautiful conditions here. Brazilian winter, not a cloud in the sky, and 25 degrees. No target. You saw the referee calling that. Just getting the other athletes to get out of his way so he can make the sign. The signal for the no target. Big responsibility on his shoulders to make sure this runs smoothly. Two puffs of the pink smoke. Perfect 12 out of 12 for Rossetti. Policeman who represents their sports section, Fiamme Oro. Svensson looking to keep pace with him, the 26-year-old. Crowd really appreciating some excellent marksmanship here. Such a difficult discipline. You have to keep that shotgun down. You see the yellow band on their shooting jackets. Has to touch that until you've shouted for pull. And then when the clay comes up, then's when you can move your shotgun up towards the proper position. Lined up on your cheek. Whoop. Couple of misses for Nilsson already. Whoop. He needs to make sure he nails these two, and he does. World Cup winner in San Marino earlier this year, so he has form in 2016. This is the other athlete who has a chance to keep his no miss target record. Now he's seeing it very well. So three still, locked on 12 apiece now, with no misses. This man has missed one. Make that two. Just seemed to snatch at the second shot. Lonely old place, when it's just you. In the Olympic final, and he does well to bag the second pair. And it's very tight, so Rossetti, Svensson and Milchev are the ones battling at the top of this table. 12 apiece for them. Hansen, Nielsen and Alrashidi scrapping as it stands at the moment. Could change for a bronze medal match place. This is a great shot. Gives you an idea of just how quick they've got to be to go from one and then switch across to the other. Last lot of four shots, last two doubles, and the 21-year-old, the youngest in the field, this to make it a perfect 16 out of 16. And he does it as well in his first Olympic Games. And shooting since he was seven. Came through the shoot-off, of course, to make it here, and he's looking really good. Now, Svensson can do the same as well. His hands are shaking a little bit there, but so used to the shooting position. And he bags another two and a perfect score of 16. Jesper Hansen. He likes fishing and hunting. It's the outdoors, that's for sure. World rank number eight. Nicely done. Well, he's giving himself a chance of a bronze medal match. Nielsen needs to shoot these two as well to get 14 as well. And he does it in quick time as well. So, at the moment, Milchev has a chance of making it 16 out of 16 himself. Might have got a complicated shoot-off. Oh, and a miss. Oh, my word. Right at the death. And that's robbed him of a chance of a gold medal match. A gold medal match to see if he got another gold like he did at Sydney. Oh, what a shame for the 48-year-old retiring after these games. Anyway, guaranteed bronze medal match. And this to put Alrashidi into a shoot-off as well. And he bags those. We have three on 14. We know that Rossetti and Svensson now will go forward to the gold medal match. Nikola Milchev has a chance of bronze, but the other three athletes all have 14, so we go to a shootout. The shoot-off will take place very quickly, so they have to recompose themselves. This is how it finished in the semi-final. Rossetti, Svensson. It looked like Milchev was going to join them on that perfect 16 out of 16 shots, but missed the last one. So, Hansen, Nielsen and Alrashidi have a chance to join Milchev in that bronze medal match. Three-way shoot-off, first person to drop out. We'll have to take a seat and they'll keep going until there's just one person left. one place available in this bronze medal match. On go the little blinders on the side for Alrashidi. Himself back into the zone. So it's Hansen who will start us. Always been there, all thereabouts. Hansen, can he get himself in with a chance of a medal? Nilsson, the man from Trouble. And he bags two as well. Now Alrashidi. Ah! Very close to being 53 years of age. This is sixth Olympic Games. He's not short of experience. This is his first final, ninth best up to now, so he's already bettered that. And they all shoot the reverse, go to high. Oh, and a miss from Hansen. And another miss. Well, Alrashidi, he hits these, and it is the man from Kuwait who will go through. Seems very relaxed, doesn't he? The oldest man in the field. Chance to take a place in the bronze medal match. And he does it. Well, Hansen and Nilsson will be desperately disappointed, I am sure, but not over the top celebrations. You may recall that Fahid Eldehani, another man from Kuwait competing under the Olympic flag, won in double trap. Chance for the man from Kuwait to do something and get a bronze here. So the two oldest competitors in the field will take their place in the bronze medal match. Hansen takes fifth, Nilsson takes sixth. Nilsson, by the way, had the most bizarre shooting accident you might ever wish to hear about. Ruptured a spleen in 2014. That accident was hunting geese. Shot a goose, ran to shoot another. The dead goose fell on him, came out of the sky, hit him, had to go to A&E saying a goose had hit him, fell out of the sky. Not sure whether they believed him or not. But he will take no further part in this competition. And it is Alrashidi up against Milchev for the bronze medal match. Pair who are very experienced here. That's the moment he confirmed his place there. No doubting hit those two targets. This is the bronze medal match. These two with a combined age of 100. So experience certainly on their side. 48-year-old Mikola Milchev, the man who got the gold at Sydney, looking for another medal before he retires. And competing under the Olympic flag, hugely popular athlete here. Look at that response from all nations. Well, I'm sure Milchev will be just putting this out of his mind. There are a few, as you can see, Ukrainians in this crowd as well. What an atmosphere. This is marvellous. Sixth Olympic Games versus somebody in their fourth Olympic Games. They've all been seen and done it before. But what would it mean to Abdullah Alrashidi, very close to turning 53? Can he do it here? Yeah, put for Milchev to shoot first. Just a reminder, like the semi-final, there are 16 targets. First miss comes from Milchev. Same format as the semi-final. Of course, Alrashidi with no country, with Kuwait being suspended by the International Olympic Committee. So he has no uniform. I notice he's wearing a Arsenal football club shirt. I'm sure that's probably perhaps a first for the Olympics, certainly a first for Arsenal Football Club in the UK. Advantage then just to Abdullah Alrashidi. So in a way it's a shame that either of these two are going to have to miss out. Both such fabulous ambassadors for the sport. Took his time on that first one, but took it very well. From Milchev, you don't have to shout pull, you can shout anything you want. A grunt will do, whatever suits you and puts you off the least. Keeps looking calm, cool and collected. A businessman from the Kuwait Shooting Club. Halfway mark, Alrashidi ahead by one, 7-8. Milchev is trailing. So then, away we go with the reverse targets. 3, 4 and 5, the targets. One target from the low house, one target from the high house, as they're known. So they are different heights, different trajectories. And different times of release, and another miss from Milchev. Now, keep calm and carry on is the message I'm sure he's telling himself, Alrashidi. Nicely done, well done. The more you shoot, the more your percentages increase of getting a medal. Still perfect in this bronze medal match. He'll raise the roof if he takes the bronze. Four more to go. Alrashidi yet to miss in this bronze medal match. Milchev in a sea of troubles, the gold medalist from Sydney. He's been competing since 1986. Started competing in 1983 when he was just 15 years of age. Again, takes his time, doesn't he? Can't leave it too long, because you will find yourself chasing a target that's disappearing. Nice finish, 14 from the 16. I think he feels that he may not be getting a medal, but great reception from the crowd for this veteran. Might be the last shot we see in competition, unless there is a shoot-off here. Ah! hit that second one very early. They're level, just one out of these last two, and the bronze will go to Abdullah Alrashidi. Ah. He's done it! Perfect 16. What a way to take the bronze. How popular is this man? Sixth Olympic Games, first final and a first medal. Bronze then to Abdullah Alrashidi, the 52-year-old competing under the Olympic flag, an independent Olympic athlete. A short pause, a bit of reflection, and now the party starts. What a moment for the man who has waited so long. 40 seconds in Atlanta, 21st in London, 14th in Sydney, 9 in both Athens and Beijing, and finally a medal. This is the moment when he cemented it. And what a semi, what a semi-final he had, and a bronze medal match. Didn't miss a shot in that bronze medal. There's confirmation of the bronze medal match, and that much of a pause, we'll move straight on to our gold medal match between the two athletes who were outstanding in the semi-finals and didn't miss a single target. This will be an interesting one between Gabriele Rossetti of Italy and Marcus Svensson of Sweden. Well, we were talking how it was a combined age of 100 for the bronze medal match, almost 102, both coming towards birthdays. Well, this a combined age of 47. Gabriele Rossetti, the Italian, 21 years of age. Marcus Svensson, 26 years of age. So the gold medal match, an all-European affair. Italy and Sweden, Gabriele Rossetti, Marcus Svensson. Gabriele Rossetti, 21 years of age, first Olympic Games. He's made a mark for himself in the junior arena, but this a real step up. Svensson, who just missed out on the finals in London with a seventh place, won here in Rio in the World Cup in April. That was his first World Cup gold. Both these athletes really young at the start of their careers, and here we are. Who can keep calm and have an old head on young shoulders and take the gold medal? 16 shots between one of these two athletes and the gold medal. Good start from Rossetti. Debut on the international stage only 6 years ago, when he was very, very young, 15-year-old. Oh. If you've grown up with it, you're comfortable with it, and Rossetti looks very comfortable. Two to start with, nicely done by Svensson. Both these two setting down a marker. Four v four in the lengthening shadows of this afternoon sunshine here in Rio. over 40 k's north of the Olympic Park, northern Rio de Janeiro, in the Deodoro cluster of venues. Rossetti quick to get the cartridges out. Barrels smoking from those two shots. Nicely done. And you've got those 30 seconds to get the doubles away. Don't hang around, but you've got to be composed at all times. So far, neither of these athletes have missed either in the semi-final or this gold medal match. I wonder if we're going to go to a shoot-off. Halfway through this gold medal match. And nothing between these two. Rossetti of Italy, Svensson of Sweden. So, on to position number five. And the targets start to come the other way. Have to hit them in the right order, of course. There's the low house. Second one, just had to feel for it a little bit, but he's still not missed a bird. Ice call from Svensson. Doesn't look bothered at all, does he? All sorts of hubbub from the announcer, the crowd, other people on the field of play. Just need to keep this under control. Keep your mind focused. Four more shots then. Can Rossetti put Svensson under pressure? Was an awful long hold before the clays were released. Didn't faze Rossetti at all. Two more to make it another perfect 16. And he does it as well. Well, Svensson needs these four to take it to a shoot-off. The gold medal to Rossetti. Well, what drama. The first target that Svensson has missed in either the semi-final or the gold medal match. The last target of the 32 he's shot. What drama. You have to feel for Marcus Svensson. Oh, dear. This is my son, says Alrashidi. Rossetti, gold medal for Italy and for Gabriele Rossetti. Real drama at the end. Smiles though from Svensson. He has shot so very, very well. These two with a special bond. Gold goes to a man who didn't miss in the semi-final or the gold medal match. That's what it means. Just Gifazzi, the national coach of the shotgun team. Bruno Rossetti is also a coach. Gabriele Rossetti making sure that everybody joins in the celebrations. That's the confirmation of the gold medal match. Marcus Svensson missing right at the end to take silver. Gabriele Rossetti taking the gold medal.
Medaille de bronze representant les athlètes olympiques indépendants.
The bronze medalist representing the independent Olympic athletes.
Medaille de bronze représentant les athlètes olympiques indépendants.
Abdullah Alrashidi.
Almost 53 years of age, world rank 54, a sixth Olympic Games. He never made the final before. And he has a bronze medal. And just listen to the reception from this crowd here. The independent Olympic athlete, Abdullah Alrashidi, takes the bronze medal. And what a moment for him. Professional falconer, he says, when he's back in Kuwait, his homeland. Bronze then for Abdullah Alrashidi.
Silver medalist representing Sweden.
Medaille de plata representando Suecia.
Marcus Svensson!
26-year-old, world ranked number 5, missed out on London final by one place. Didn't miss out here and shot perfectly until that agonizing last shot. Sure what happened there, handed the gold to Rossetti, but what an excellent result. Got the gold, the top step of the podium in the World Cup here in April. Couldn't manage it here. It is a silver for Sweden and Marcus Svensson.
Representando a Itália,
Gabriele Rossetti.
Well, he came through a shoot-off in qualifying, only just scraped in to the final, and then he didn't miss a target. The semi-final was perfect, the gold medal match was perfect, and at just 21 years of age, at his first Olympic Games, how about that? He has a gold. Been shooting since he was 7. Debut 6 years ago for Italy. Policeman who shoots for their sports team. It is gold for Italy and Gabriele Rossetti.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Italy.
Signore e signori, o inno da Italia.
Vincent Hancock, the man who won the last two Olympic golds, didn't make it through qualifying. Is this the new face of skeet shooting. This is how it's finished. Abdullah Alrashidi with the bronze medal. Sweden's Marcus Svensson with silver. And the young man, the 21-year-old, Gabriele Rossetti, wins the gold for Italy.